MyEducation BC, the first time you log in, you will have to change your password. You will receive this information from your site secretary or administrator. Usernames will usually follow the format of first initial last name, followed by the digits 6 and 0. Your temporary password will be given to you by your site secretary or your administrator. When you click login, the first time you do this, it will say your password has expired. This is normal behavior. Please create a new one. Click OK. It has your password requirements here: minimum length of 8 characters, at least one number, at least one capital and lowercase letter, at least one symbol that isn't a letter or number, and then there is some requirements around not using the word password, your login name, first name, etc. in your password itself. So, enter your current password. That's the temporary one you've just entered. If you think you've mistyped it, make sure you get it right. And then your new password, following the rules as given twice. So new password and confirm the same one. Hit OK. If everything's all right, it will get you into the system. From this point, you do want to go into Set Preferences before you do anything else and make some changes. Set Preferences in the top right-hand corner. Click there. This will open up a pop-up. If for some reason the pop-up looks smaller than it needs to be, it may be because you've zoomed in on your browser window. And on a Mac, it's Command plus in Chrome or Command minus to zoom in. So if the text is too small, you can zoom, but you might have to resize your window if you have zoomed in. But now that I have, it's easy to see. Your default locale is Canada. It might be set to US to start. Canada will give you the day, month, year format, as well as spell check, Canadian spell check. If you have it in US, you would get month, day, year, and US spell check. At this point in time of June of 2015, we are aware of some reports that are not running properly if you pick the Canada locale. This seems to only be affecting Office users, but Canada should be a safe pick. If you ever run into a report that you can't run, it may be because of this. I'm going to pick Canada. Autosave interval, leave it at 5. Leave disable user unchecked. Records per page will be how many student records in each list do you see per page. So for most classroom teachers, 30 is going to be fine. Show your lower page controls if you're dealing with large lists. This is nice because there will be some page controls at the bottom of the list. Warn on save, leave that on. Next step is security. In here, if you don't fill this out at this point in time on your first login, it'll force you to do this on your second login. So you might as well do this right now. Primary email address should be your PRN email address. Alternate email, at this point in time, there's no functionality. The security question is what you're going to use if you forget your password. In the production environment, when you log in, or before you log in, there's a link that says "Forgot my password." This will enable you to do a self-service password reset if you have selected a question and if you have filled in a security answer. You do need to remember this to use the password reset. One more point in this location is if you need to change your password, which you do every 90 days, this is where you'd come in here, hit the change button. You have the option to change your password. If you've forgotten the requirements are right there and you can see them. And if at this point in time I don't want to change my password, there's a link that says don't change. From here I click OK. I've set my preferences, I've set my primary email and my security question, and you've finished the very basic login procedure. And the one last step before I actually finish is I need to put in my current password before I make changes to security. Just to make sure you are who you are. And now you've finished that. Remember, when you walk away from your station, log off and lock your session, lock your computer, and log off from your session if you're not going to be using it. And that's a quick look at your first login.